Looking at the different opportunities that I had when I left Krispy Kreme in 2014, I wanted to do something that had a connection to the community, that had a passion around the product and around the brand, and that was kind of what I felt when I explored the Abbott's brand. Here in the South, most of the time, they think custard is a pudding base, but you know, custard-filled donuts, for example. One of the things that I hear a lot of is frozen custard. Just, you know, I was thinking it's going to be like lumpy or like sour cream, and I'm like, you're far from being correct. I said, it's really the way ice cream was supposed to be. I said, there's three things that make custard different. It's the process, it's the product, and then it's the freshness. And I explained that we order our mix, you know, straight from the farm on a Thursday. It's as fresh as 8 days from the farm, no more older than 20. I felt like Abbott's was where Krispy Kreme was in about 1980. They were on the brink of getting ready to go nationwide, and great family tied brand that, you know, I felt like that's what Abbott's was at that point. Abbott's is a family thing. I mean, that's the biggest thing that sort of attracted me. Having your family work alongside your family, it is a family affair. My wife runs the shop, opens the shop almost every morning, not because she has to, because she wants to. And it's transitioned from me and her working together to we're picking the flavors to where it's, we would rotate each day, I'd do a day, she'd do a day, to where now she sets the flavors and I follow the menu that she tells me to do. And if I don't, I get in trouble.
Some days I look at them like, what were you thinking? But it is fun for the most part. Me and my dad sort of butt heads because we have a lot in common, but it's good.
They seem to be a common thing.
Yeah. We like working together, me and my mom.
Caitlin and I try to think about what the kids are going to like and making sure we have a fruit and making sure we have a peanut butter. And you just kind of fix on what's going to be the easiest. We tried to work together, and then it got a little competitive because whose flavors were selling better on the days that people were working.
I think the reason for considering to open an Abbott's would be simplicity. It may sound kind of strange, but I think the model is really simple. It's not as complex as a, per se, a Krispy Kreme or a Jim or whatever else you may consider. The product is one product line that you use, and you use that base to manufacture all your menu. The menu has a vast amount of extensions you can do with it, and the product carries. I mean, the heritage of the company, I think, is the most attracting, one of the biggest things that attracted me. 1902, the history behind it, it's been around a long time. And I think the legacy is what really makes me the proudest to be part of that. The Happily Ever After slogan that's been adopted has a lot of meaning. It's a great marketing tagline, I guess you could say. Happily Ever After, after every event, think of Abbott's. But I think there's, you know, the story as it goes and ties to the franchisee and to the operators and to, you know, ultimately is creating something that's lasting, in my mind. I think creating that experience, and you only do it, you do it with a product and the consumer. One person at a time, one product served at a time, and focus on quality and service. Abbott's Frozen Custard, Happily Ever After.